Yeah, what's up, guys? It's Chris B, the drummer boy, aka the king of new wave. And I've been getting a lot of email, people buzzing me saying, bro, what are you using for your sounds? How do you do this? How do you do that? So I just thought to myself that maybe I should just put a tutorial for you guys to just see how I actually made one of my sounds, you know. So for this tutorial, I'll be using Reason and Logic. You could use any DAW to achieve this. So let's get right into it. Okay, so I started by using a clap actually, to get a hip hop bounce. You know, like 1/4 kind of sound. Sounds like this. So while this was going on, I used to tell people the best way to make your beat is to create it from your head. If you create your beat in your head, you can, once you have a sweet sound inside your head, all you just need to do is just put the sound down the way you are hearing it in your head. I don't know if you hear it, but just imagine it. If you can beatbox, do it. Most times I record most of my beats on my phone. Like, I'll just go, I might be in a party or something and just go to somewhere and just do. So once I get inside the studio, I want to achieve that same with my, in my DAW or whatever thing I'm using at that time. So while this is going on, I added a shaker to give me a run actually. Do you understand? It sounds like this. If you have an artist in here now, you see people already nodding their head to your sound before you add the melody or anything. Plus, I like to start with the drums. It gives me more room. It gives me space. I won't get lost in the middle of the song. So I like to start with the drums to build it from the drums. So I added a clank sound to give me that nice Afrobeat sound. Sounds like this. So I added this shaker to give me that run. So after the shaker, I added the kick. So I wanted a kind of bounce that comes once in a while, you know, that comes boom, 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 instead of the normal straight bounce that we know for Afrobeat. So I switched it. You can say, yeah, you can call that my style. Thank you. So added a clav to sound to. I combined a clav and a clank. I don't know. A clav is, you know, a clav. Google clav. You get clav, I beg. A clank is kind of like beating two sticks together. Yeah, that's a closer version of a clank. But a clank. So I mixed the clank, a shaker, and a clav together to get the sound. So the clap, there's one clap that comes immediately, that comes every 4/4 bar in the song. Sounds like this. I added reverb to the clap to make it juicy. Yeah, that's the word, to make it juicy. Like this. So after completing the drums, I added a muted guitar. Sounds like this. I believe that's the heart of the song. That's what holds the that's what holds all the sound together. Apart from the guitar that we're still going to talk about. So this I added this and another clap that comes in the beginning of the song. It sounds like this. It's actually a clap, a trap clap with a delay on it, with a little bit of reverb. Then you can get this. You could use any clap. Does not matter whether you're using this clap or that clap. You could use anyone to get this. Plus, you could get most of my kits on my website. You'll see it in the link below this video if you're watching on anywhere. So after this, I added a sample, a signature sample. My signature actually sounds like this. Yeah, you hear this in every 4/4 bar too. Then after I did that, I added another. I added this. This is a sine wave. I compressed it. I added a delay. I added reverb. I messed around with the attack, release, decay, sustain a bit. Just tweaked one or two things. Then you can get this. Let's listen together with the muted guitar we played earlier. Then you could use your EQ to like separate the sounds. You don't want the frequencies to be clashing. You don't want the frequency from your mid, from your muted guitar and your sine wave to be clashing, so you use your EQ to like correct that a bit so you have a perfect sound. So in this case I chopped about I think from 200 hertz to 500 hertz, somewhere around 250 hertz I reduced the gain. I dropped the gain there, and I did the same thing for. I cut the low for the muted guitar from like 50 hertz to like, let's say about 100 hertz. Then I boosted the mid. So you know we reduced the mid for the sine wave. So you have a perfect sound like this. Play everything together. So you can see everything is balanced. You don't have one sound going above the other one. You want to have a perfect sound, even while the artist is in the studio. So you keep them in the groove. You don't want them to get tired, or the artist is hyper and you are just bringing everything down. So. So that's like the whole song, and that's the intro of the song. So for the chorus, I reduced some things. I removed the bones, so I added another sound. I call this sound a romantic kind of sound, a romantic guitar. You know, I think ladies love this kind of sound. Sorry, guys. So sounds like this. Thank you. So, sounds like this together with the beat, with the rest of the things we've talked about earlier. So with all the guitar and the rest of the stuff that we added to the song, I was still looking for something that could shake the sob in the club. Hey, see rhymes, that could shake the sob in the club. So I was looking for something like that. So I added an 808. And this 808, you could get this 808 by using any 808 sample that you have. But I did this by using that same sine wave, added a little beat crusher. Let me see here. Beat crusher, compressor, EQ. Yeah, EQ, and I messed around with the attack and release in the sampler I'm using. You could use any sampler. And don't forget, you could get this, you could get most of my kits on my website, so just check them out. Okay, the 808 sounds like this. You might not be able to hear that if you're using a phone or anything, but you need a headphone or a nice pair of monitor. So while this the whole beat is this. This is basically the whole beat. So what I just did was I added a few stuffs like a block, a wood block from Purity. I added a wood block from Purity. Who uses that? You get, and I panned it from left to the right, so it gives you that wild sound. So I added that, and for the hook, we didn't change anything. We just returned all those things that we had from the intro. We brought them back to the hook, and I just added a few more things. I added a bass and a brass. The brass, you could get this brass on Logic. It's called Mellow Brass on Logic. But you need to upgrade your Logic to get the brass, though. Sounds like this. Bass sounds like this. You mess around with the subs and the speakers. You know, the DJ likes to get the, I'm a DJ, so we like to get the sound, we like to get it as heavy as possible. You know, you feel like you are remaking the song when the song is heavy. That's everything about the song. That's, you don't want to add too much. You don't want your vocals fighting with your instrumentals. You want everything to be balanced in a way that the listeners enjoy what they're listening to. So that's pretty much the whole song. And for the verse, I repeated the same thing I used for the chorus, and I was changing some things, I panned some things, so when you hardly notice that I'm even using the same sound. What you just see is, you know that, okay, this thing is coming in, this thing is going back. Yeah, feeling this, the sounds arise, you hear a drum feel from here, you hear a drum feel from there, so that's pretty much everything. And for the verse, the last part of the verse, I added a bass. high life kind of bass, Nigerian high life kind of bass. So it sounds like this. Do you understand? So I added that bass to make it more African, and that's the whole song. That's the whole song. So yeah, that's the whole song. That's the whole song. So you just be creative around it. You don't really need to do it the way I did it. So you could pick the clav pattern and just with another melody, just create something. Be creative about it. Just imagine where it sounds. I like to add EDM in most of my stuff. So I like to add electronic into it. So once people hear it, they'll know, okay, this is Chris. This is Chris sound. Just feel free, sample anything you could. I've done too many samplings that I can remember. I've taken a mic to my generator before and, you know, just use the generator sound to just make sound. Yeah, just playing around with some new stuff, and that's basically how I made the beat Pana by Techno. Well, by now I'm sure we all know that the song is a hit record, and thanks to God, thanks to everybody supporting the brand. And and if there's any of my song that I produce that you'd like to see a tutorial on, you could leave a comment and I'll see if I could get that to you as well. And don't forget to visit the website. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to comment. God bless you. Chris B, the drummer boy. Love you guys.
vibra, oh baby vibra. Baby you too sweet, you fajaba. My baby dance to do the lagbaja. I can take you to Papalada. Vibra, oh baby vibra. Baby you too sweet, you fajaba. My baby dance to do the lagbaja.
It's Chris with the Travel Guy.